James Gunn, the GOAT by Yatyn Anderson. James Gunn was born and raised in St. Louis, Missouri to Loretta and James Francis Gunn. Most of Gunn's family were lawyers, but James decided to go down the film path pretty early in his life. By the age of 12, James had already started making 8mm films, most of which were his brothers being disemboweled by zombies. When he got older, he dropped out of college to pursue his rock and roll career. After nothing came from this, he went back to finish college at St. Louis University. After he graduated, Gunn started writing The Toy Collector and began working for Troma Studios, America's leading B-movie production company. While there, he wrote and produced the cult classic Romeo and Juliet in 1996. And with Lloyd Kaufman, he wrote the book All I Need to Know About Filming I Learned from the Toxic Avenger. This is the time in his life where he decided if he wanted to be an actor or a director. The turning point in Gunn's life is when he visited France in 1997 and had a spiritual awakening. Around this time, he quit Troma Films and left New York for Los Angeles. When he got there, he wrote and acted for the movie The Specials. After a series of small budget films such as Spy vs. Spy, Scooby-Doo 2, and Slither, he eventually landed the Guardians of the Galaxy job.
It's a pleasure to meet you again.
You
first of all, I need to thank you, one, for bringing my childhood onto the screen with things like a young Kurt Russell,
yeah.
Michael Knight, Pac-Man.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, yeah.
I got to ask you this, because I'm a huge Troma fan, and if the 1996 version of you at Troma got wind of what you're doing 20 years later, how would he react?
I always get into trouble with these questions, but because I don't know what to say exactly, but I always wanted to make this type of movie.
Sure.
So I think I would be happy that I'm doing what I'm doing, but I think that was always what I was looking to do.
Sure.
So it would be a pleasant surprise.
Yeah. I was in actually at the convention when they announced that they were doing this. I don't think you were attached, if I remember right, when they first announced it.
No, I wasn't.
And
I
so,
was not.
And there was two reactions that I always remember hearing. There was cheers from us geeks who knew about it.
Yeah.
And then kind of, I'd almost say slight confusion. And
yes.
They're like, what is the Guardians of the
yes.
Galaxy?
Yes.
Why do you think people attach themselves to this franchise so well?
I think that in a way, this is the first MCU franchise that's first and foremost a cinematic franchise.
Mm-hmm.
I think that people have gotten to know these characters through the movies more so than from cartoons or comic books or whatever.
Sure.
And in that way, we've had a lot more freedom. I also think this is truly the franchise that's about outcasts for outcasts.
Yeah.
There is no doubt that Guardians of the Galaxy Volume 1 and 2 are his biggest films to date. The first movie received a 91% on Rotten Tomatoes and also a Critics' Choice for the Best Action Movie of 2014. As for the Guardians of the Galaxy Volume 2, it received 48% on Rotten Tomatoes and the Teen Choice for Sci-Fi Picture of the Year. The movie together generated over $1.63 billion at the box office, breaking all types of records. Recently, Gunn was reinstated as director of Guardians of the Galaxy Volume 3 after some controversy over some old distasteful tweets he made some years ago about pedophilia. Prior to his reinstatement, many of his actors, such as Dave Bautista, came out against the firing, threatening not to do any more movies unless he was brought back. Now, as he is back as director, he has already started filming and plans to release in 2020.